Hi everybody, welcome back. I'm Melissa Muir. Today I want to introduce you to a new tool in my studio. I've had this now for about a week and I have a prototype, but they are about to launch their Kickstarter on this and wanted me to try it out and see kind of what I thought about this machine. Now, if you've been following me, you know that I have multiple lasers here in my studio and they've all been on the lower end of things, both on the cost as well as the power. Well, this one, even though the cost is going to be about the same range as some of the others, the power is so much more. This is a 30-watt fiber laser by ComMarker. This is the new B6. Now, there is a model that's very similar to this called the B4. However, there are some pretty big improvements on this, one of which being the autofocus. So I no longer have to sit and try to line up my little dots to make sure that I'm in focus. It will do all of that for me. In addition to that, they've also built an optional enclosure for this, and they've built in safety features so that if you open up that door, the laser is then going to stop. The top has threaded holes, but it's 150 millimeters. So that's 15 centimeters by 15 centimeters is now my working area, which is a huge improvement from the 75 millimeters that I've been working on. Now, another thing that they've done with this laser is make it a lot lighter. So the predecessor to this, the B4, is about 42 pounds or around 20 kilograms, not quite. And this one is about 13 kilograms, which is around 30 pounds. So you've got a big weight difference on that as well. The footprint is much smaller. However, my working size is still the same. So like I said, they've made some big improvements on this machine. Now, since this is also a step up in the laser technology for me, it's also a step up in the learning curve for me. The light burn is something that a lot of different people who work with the lasers or 3D printing are already going to be familiar with and using. But the lasers that I have purchased have all had built-in applications that they can use, and they're pretty user-friendly. Light burn is a step up, and so you have to have a little bit more knowledge in the workings of that program. Let's jump in and see what this laser is about. Now, this machine is a little bit more involved. However, the setup is really easy and it goes quite quickly. So everything is put together and they've included the tools necessary for that. And the best part about the hex wrenches that they sent, there's a little band that holds everything together so you won't lose even the tools. Setting up the machine is pretty easy, and once you have that all done, then it's time to plug everything in. First, you have your power cord, and then there's a couple ports for both the rotary device as well as your pedal. On the other side, you have the enclosure cable port as well as the autofocus cable port and the data cable. And now we're ready to get started. So this is what it looks like. Now, there's a couple of different ways that you can configure this, and for me, I chose to put the laser head and the base onto the power unit of the laser. So you can have this sitting on its own, and then the laser head itself can sit by itself. But for me to, you know, I'm running out of space in here, so I figured it would be better to do this. Now, another thing that's really cool is they sent a lot of materials to test out. So this is kind of fun. One of the things that I've received with multiples of my lasers are these business cards. However, this is the first time I've actually received one that's kind of strong and sturdy. Usually they're really flimsy. So they have not cheaped out at all on the materials that they're including. And there's even a pair of safety glasses. And the thing that I like about these glasses too is on here it tells you what its rating is for the different laser beams. The bed of the laser has threaded holes, and that is so that you can take these guides and you can place them wherever you need to, and then you can just screw them into place. And so that's going to allow you to just have repeatable results if you are going to be doing a batch run of items. So let's say I'm doing a coin, then I'm going to go ahead and get this into position, line it up with the laser so that I can do one coin, put in another coin, and then run it, put in another coin, and run it. So to turn on the machine, I'm going to push and hold the power button until everything lights up. Now I have the ability to stop this. This is an emergency stop. Then I also can see that it's running. I have an up down button, which will allow me to make the laser head go up or down. So that's one way of doing it, but there's also another way. Now the first thing I need to do is to focus my laser. Right now this dot right here is really big and it's very fuzzy. And that tells me that it is not currently in focus. There's another dot that sits here on my bed. You can see that right there. That is going to be my focus point. So what I want to do first is I'm going to move whatever my object is to the same height that I'm going to be engraving at, and then I can press the auto button on the top of the machine. So when I come onto the machine here at the very top, it's going to give me a warning, be telling me that it is out of focus. So I'm going to press this down button, and then I can also, there's a way that I can also drop this down manually if I wanted to. So you can either do it by the button or you can do it manually, whichever. And once I get it down a little bit, then it gives me the ability to hit this auto. So now I'm going to press that and it's going to, and you can see right here that it's making that change for me. It's going to kind of fine tune that. And if we want to, we can actually look at the settings here and this will show us where we're at. My machine is set for about 258 for my focal length. And you'll see right here that it's kind of sitting at 257, 258. And so that's actually really good. That's where we want to be. Now when I move my object back in, notice that that dot is much smaller and a lot more in focus. So next thing I'm going to do is to frame my piece. So I already have this loaded. And this is going to show me where my piece is going to be. So in this case, maybe I'm gonna put my object up here and maybe I'll add some text here in a little bit. For right now, let's just go ahead and stick with our object. I already have my settings loaded, so I'm just going to tell this to start. Now it's very important also that you do not look at that laser. Make sure that you have your appropriate gear for that. You can also see some off-gassing here. You want to make sure you have some good ventilation in your studio as well while you're doing this. You can see we're getting a beautiful white mark here on this slate. Now there are settings that I can use to make this even deeper if I wanted to. You can even go through the slate if that's what you really want. That's not what we're doing today. And that took a minute and a half, and look at how beautiful that is. Air purification is a big thing, and that's something that you're definitely going to want to have. So in my studio, I am using a solder pure, and then what I can do is just mount this to wherever so I can pull harmful fumes and particles away. Now while the rotary tool can be used for many different objects, in my studio, the most use that they're going to get is with the bracelets and rings. Depending on your settings, you can either mark or deep engrave your object. In this case, I've added a simple heart design. Anytime I work with a new machine like this, I'm going to be running all kinds of test grids as well as test patterns and trying out different materials. So that is what you see here. Now, again, I've only had this laser for just a couple of weeks, so I'm not really beyond that testing phase yet. However, I have a lot of really good examples of different tests that I have run. So you'll notice here, so we've got some that maybe didn't work so well. And then by changing different settings, we start to get some different things. Now this is stainless steel, and I actually got some really deep engraves on this, as well as the dark markings. This one I've already deep engraved, and then I polished it, and you can see how well that turned out. I've been working with sterling silver, with brass, and again, I actually got some pretty deep engraves. This one already has been sanded, as well as polished, and you can see that we still have a great impression on there, actually on both sides of this. This one is sterling silver. Now, while I don't have as deep of an impression on this one, it still did go pretty deep. Again, I have already sanded this down to see how far down I needed to go to remove it, and I have not yet removed everything. When I got into the brass coins, I actually had a lot of failures, and then I started to get some more successes. Trying to figure out the settings was a little bit more interesting just because there are so many other options. But in the end, I ended up with some really deep impressions on this. So I'm very excited to play with this a little bit more coming up. In addition, there is a rotary tool, so I can do things such as rings and bracelets. And then I can work with some different materials also. Just check out the detail on this engraving. It's pretty impressive, the detail that you can get with photographs or anything else. In addition, I can also work with some alternative materials such as slate. Now this one, I did a lighter marking, but again, I can feel that engraving deep down into it. And here I went a little bit deeper. So maybe you guys can see there, like the depth that I got on that. Now, if we look at the size of the machine, you can see it's actually not really all that big. It does not take up that much space on my bench. Now, one of the things that I have learned about ComMarker, as they are a newer company for me to work with, they actually are releasing multiple lasers. So here they have the 30 watt, but they also have a 60 watt MOPA, and that's going to allow you to engrave faster, deeper, as well as adding color. When you're working with a 30 watt laser, you really don't have the power that you need for the coloring on like stainless or silver or anything like that. So you're kind of limited more to the grayscale. But as you just saw, it still works much faster than any of the machines that I've had in my studio to this point. And it's not that difficult to use. However, I will say there is a bit of a learning curve because, like I said, we are stepping up to a more professional machine. And so you're working with more professional tools such as Lightburn and EasyCAD. I'm kind of excited to put this to work a little bit more here in my studio. Like I said, I've only had just a very short time to work with it. And in that short time, I have learned so much and I've already seen how this is going to be really useful in my jewelry studio. Not only can I do a light marking for when I want to hand engrave, but I can also do some really good deep details, and I can even cut metal up to 0.5 millimeter. If you're interested in this machine, be sure to check out their Kickstarter. This machine on the early bird special is going to be under $2,000. Not much, but a little bit. And that is phenomenal, seeing as how that is about the same amount that I have spent on my machines that are much lower wattage than this and just do not have the same kind of capabilities. And while I know that those prices can be kind of big as far as their sticker goes, when it comes to having a professional tool in your studio, it's definitely worth the investment. We'll see you guys on the next video. Take care.